Hello and welcome to ITC TechShare. I'm Tom Grissom. In this episode, I will provide an overview of the College of Education and Professional Studies technology-enhanced classrooms. This project began over a decade ago as a goal set by the CEPS Technology Committee to have every classroom become technology-enhanced. Since that time, we have updated and maintained our classrooms with the latest educational technologies, including high-speed internet access, wireless access, overhead projectors, document cameras, laptop connections, and interactive whiteboards. With over 30 technology-enhanced classrooms in our college and over 120 TECs on campus, we have strived to maintain a consistent experience between classrooms. Once you understand the basics of operation, it will be easy to move from room to room to take advantage of the high-tech capabilities our classrooms offer. Earlier this week, I gave a presentation providing an overview of our technology-enhanced classrooms and the capabilities our TECs provide our faculty and students. Without further delay, let's take a look. And welcome to our technology-enhanced classrooms. What I'd like to do today is give you a quick overview of the capabilities that our technology-enhanced classrooms have. Our typical classroom has an overhead projector. We have a podium that's lockable. Inside the podium is housed a main computer. We also have document cameras in most of our classrooms. And inside the podiums are the magic black boxes that make all of this equipment work together. In addition, we have smart boards mounted to the walls in the front of the rooms that is used to project the image up on the screen. So let's just do a quick run through. And typically on most classrooms, whenever I open up the right-hand door, we have a switch box, and we try making these as similar as possible. So in this example here, we have an Extron switch box, and you'll see button number one says computer, button number two is labeled laptop, and button number three is labeled dock camera. Button number four in this example is not labeled, it's not used. Also on the right-hand side, if I pan down here a little bit, you'll see in this case, it's a Dell computer, this is our main CPU. And then underneath the keyboard tray, if I open up the other two doors, this is where the magic black boxes are stored. And in this case, we have a sound amplifier and a VCR-DVD combination unit. So this allows us to have sound that we can turn up and down. So this top box is our sound controller. So I can use the up and down volume knob here to control the sound level. Same thing with the VCR or DVD. Underneath that is a regular VHS tape player and a DVD tape player. So if I press the open close button, I can pop in my DVD and then show a movie. So let me close this up and talk a little bit about how to connect a laptop computer. Many of our students have laptops, so we would like to be able to connect our laptop. And on most of our classrooms, in fact, all of our technology-enhanced classrooms, we have a VGA cable, and it's labeled to laptop. Most computers have a VGA output. So on this particular model, this is a little netbook, but on the side, you'll see the female connector for the VGA. To connect the video source to the projector, make sure that it's plugged in properly. It's trapezoid in shape, so make sure it's the correct way up. Plug that in. And then if you so choose, we also have a sound jack, a little 1/8 inch jack here that I can plug into my headphone jack. What this will do is instead of using the laptop speakers where very few people would be able to hear, be able to listen to the sound on the bigger speakers. So in this example, I need to go to show my laptop. So I'm going to press button number two on my switch box. And then let's go up to the sound feature here. So if we go here to widescreen, you'll see that I have my laptop screen showing here. And let's just play a little sound clip. Click on a little media player here and click on the play button. And you can hear the sound come out the speakers. If I go down and look at my volume control knob here. So if I want to turn that up a little bit so everybody can hear, or I can turn it down. So I just adjust the volume with that. Okay, let me go ahead and stop the music here and close this out. So that's an example of how to connect the laptop to the computer.
Projector.
Now, the other thing that you need to be aware of, all of our projectors are NEC brand projectors and they have remotes. Probably the number one call that we get for help in the ITC is somebody will see this lovely blue screen. So let me switch this to video mode here. And if you notice, it says video up here in the upper right-hand corner. So the projector is ready to show a VHS tape or a DVD. To get it back to computer mode, this is the older style remote, I'm going to press the RGB button, and that changes my projector channel back to displaying the computer. On the newer style remotes, they finally started calling that the computer one button. Okay, so the other thing I'd like to very quickly explain is our document camera. So again, the majority of our classrooms have document cameras. There is an on-off switch located on the left-hand side. This one happens to be a Canon brand document camera. I can fold up the lights here. And there's also a little lock lever here, so I'm going to just press that and bring up my camera. Some of our cameras have dust caps, so check and see if there is a dust cap involved. And if there's not, let me throw something up here so you can see it. I'm going to put the remote up here. And let me go ahead and I want to display the document camera up on the computer screen. So to do that, I'm going to go back to my switch box and press button number 3, which is labeled Dock Camera. And as you can see up on the screen, I have it here. Document cameras are great for three-dimensional objects like this, or displaying a book, or even a model of a heart, some anatomy lessons, whatever you'd like to do, rocks and minerals. It's just a really great feature to add to a classroom. Let me go ahead and switch back to button number 1. Button number 1 is my main computer that's located here inside the podium. And let's say that you have a PowerPoint presentation on one of these little bitty flash drives. So I'm going to switch to computer 1. All of our classrooms have a USB extension which is connected to the computer inside this podium. They're labeled thumb drive. And to bring that up, just simply plug in your thumb drive. The computer will recognize it, install it. You can open up the PowerPoint and then display it on the screen. The last feature I would like to talk about is our SmartBoard software itself. So what I'd like to do now is start up the Smart Notebook software. Let me close or minimize this. And to start the Smart Notebook software, just simply double click. That opens up the Smart Notebook software. And at this point, you're in whiteboard mode. So you can bring up, you'll notice here on the trays, we have different colors of markers. So I, for example, can type the word red. And I even have an electronic eraser here that I can erase things. So if you want to write notes, that's what the Smart Notebook software is all about. So that's just a very quick overview of the capabilities that we have in all of our technology-enhanced classrooms. It's very versatile. You can bring in your own laptop. In future episodes, I will talk about some specific models and like connecting a Macintosh, which requires a special adapter for this VGA, as well as connecting XP computers. So just a real quick overview. Hope you enjoy it, and I hope you enjoy our technology-enhanced classrooms here at Eastern Illinois University.